A Mysterious Monument, Part 2, looking at the last 5 commandments. Coming up next. The Georgia Guidestones are sometimes referred to as the American Stonehenge. A granite monument of 6 stones erected in Albert County, Georgia in 1980. The 4 main tablet stones are engraved in 8 languages, one on each side. English, Spanish, Swahili, Hindi, Hebrew, and Arabic, Chinese, and Russian, each relaying 10 new commandments for an age of reason. The stones are said to be lined up with certain astronomical features. Now, here are the last 5 commandments as inscribed on the stones. And number 6, let all nations rule internally, resolving external disputes in world court. Number 7, avoid petty laws and useless officials. Number 8, balance personal rights with social duties. Number 9, prize truth, beauty, love, seeking harmony with the infinite. Be not a cancer on the earth, leave room for nature. And that was commandments number 6 through 10. Now let's take a closer look at number 6. It says, let all nations rule internally, resolving external disputes in world court. Now that sounds really good, but the question is, will it happen? And I absolutely, seriously doubt it. Okay? Now, here's a question. Can the rest of the world sit by while some dictators flex their muscles, build nuclear weapons, and be a threat to their neighbors? And even the world at large, I don't think so. The answer is no. America and some of the nations will not sit by while you've got nations like Iran and North Korea and the like build nuclear weapons and be a threat to the region, to their own region, and to the wider world community. It is very difficult to for some people to sit by and watch these things. China can do so, but certainly America wouldn't do it. And Israel, who has threats all around her, will not sit by and watch while these things take place. So we have a problem because, you know what, when the world court convenes, sometimes it might be too late. All right? So, you know, some world leaders seem to have been created by the devil himself, the way in which they destroy their own societies by even mass murders, like people like Saddam and Assad and those people, and use military exercises to subjugate their population. I tell you, there has to be some sort of intervention from the outside, from the free world. Otherwise, you're going to have mass chaos in many countries as to the way that some of these leaders go about thinking that they own their countries and they own their people. All right, so that was commandment number 6. Number 7 says avoid petty laws and useless officials. Now, here's the question. How are we going to avoid petty laws? Now, first off, it seems that the poor and minorities are the ones affected by these laws most of the time. And also, racism in every society needs to be addressed, okay? But I believe more so in the United States, racism definitely has a part to play in some of these petty and useless laws that are enacted in some of these countries, right? Also, too, the church needs to get involved. I believe the church is guilty of this racism also, and is extremely silent on the matter. right? America's greatest shame is racism, and will be judged because no other country has had the gospel preached so freely over the time of its existence. And yet, unfortunately, many in this United States of a certain race seem to be extremely, almost inherently racist towards the African Americans, but basically towards everybody else, right? Well, the African Americans really get the brunt of this racism. It's time for this stuff to stop, and if not, then things definitely will not change. Now, avoiding useless officials is going to be a tremendous task to accomplish. And once again, we have to begin in the United States of America, right? Just laws governing performance and accountability of elected officials must be in place. Okay, let me read that again. Right, just laws governing performance and accountability of elected officials must be in place. Also, the ability to bring a vote of no confidence within a set time should also be a vehicle available to be used to replace incompetent and non-performing officials. Those are my viewpoints on this commandment number 7. Now, number 8, it says balance personal rights with social duties. Right, back in the United States again. Now, the United States Constitution is probably the best known for its balance of personal rights and social duties. But the implementation of those rights and duties, I believe, is where things begin to fall apart, because the laws are not always crafted fairly and equally across the board, and at times seems to be in conflict with the very constitution of the said people and country it is supposed to be protecting, right? It seems like the Constitution seems to apply to some and really not to others. People's constitutional rights have been abused over and over. You see the way things are happening with police towards a certain race. I've seen videos where we've got Caucasians literally pulling a gun on the white police officers, and they do not shoot them. But I always say, let it be a person of color, African-American, Hispanic, or somebody else, and they'll be dead on the spot without even a second thought. And sometimes I wonder about that. Why is it that the rules are different for Caucasians, and certainly the rules are not in place for African-Americans and other minorities? It is a travesty. It is a sin. And like I said, America will pay the price for this type of behavior, right? So I believe that race, ethnicity, and social economics in America play a big role in this dilemma, right? So number 9, it says, prize truth, beauty, love, seeking harmony with the infinite. Okay, now the answer to this one is found in the Bible and in the person of Jesus Christ himself. Now in Acts 4 verse 12, it reads like this. It says, nor is there salvation in any other, for there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. Okay, and that is as clear as I know it. There is no this is a no-brainer, really. You know, harmony with the infinite God Almighty is through Christ only, who teaches love and truth. So it talks about prize truth, beauty, love, seeking harmony with the infinite. That's number 9. And I'm saying that the gospel of Jesus Christ that came through him and the apostles, Paul, Peter, John, Luke, John, Mark, and all of those, Timothy, and those who, and I can name the rest, James, and a few more, who preach the gospel, preach truth and love. And there is nothing more beautiful than the truth and the love which the gospel teaches and gives us the harmony with God himself. This is the gospel message right here. Number 9 is asking for the gospel message that will change lives and change the nations and ultimately change the world. So there you have it. Number 9 is wrapped up in scripture. This is where the answer lies. And if we would only adhere to these things, I believe that the world would certainly be a better place. Now, number 10, it says, be not a cancer on the earth, leave room for nature. Once again, it said, be not a cancer on the earth, leave room for nature. Now, so mankind is the reason for the extinction of both animal and plant life on the earth. Overpopulation is not the cause, but none other than greed, stupidity, and the lack of basic common sense are the reasons for the decline in fish, drinking water, animals, plant, and food that we experience in this world. This decline is directly because of human stupidity and their lack of intervention, their lack of preserving the earth as we received it from God. And so things are chaotic. There's not a lot of drinking water in certain places. Certain places have become deserts because they have removed the trees. And I'll read on that because I've got some stuff written down. And but you know, by reason of pollution and the destruction of all things natural, we are reducing this planet to a wasteland, barely able to support life. And that is exactly what we're doing. Now, you see, nature is under fire as we continue to overfish, kill rare and exotic animals, cut more trees than we plant, leave vast wastelands to erosion and the harsh elements of wind and the rain. We are also causing more and more damage, even when we set fires in certain places and vast forests and stuff gets destroyed. We are destroying this earth, right? We remove invasive species from their natural habitat where there is balance, to places where now we are struggling to maintain the levels of our own natural endemic species, right? And I'm going to give you an example of that, right? The brown tree snake, snakehead fish, northern snakehead, red lionfish, and the Burmese python are some of the invasive species introduced into North America or into America itself, which are now wreaking havoc on the ecological balance of this country. Okay, those are facts. This is what's happening. So these monuments are good in the sense that some of these laws, that the commandments that are placed on these monuments, really make you think about the situation that we find ourselves in this earth. And it's calling for some realistic changes. However, the question is, what form does those changes take? How do we go about making those changes? And are these changes going to be morally and just and right for humankind or human beings? This is the question. We're not really sure what is being proposed or what's being asked of us. Okay, but it talks about a new age of reason. And so we have to really think long and hard about this monument. First of all, we don't even know where it came from and who really erected it and placed it there. Let me read the Ten Commandments as they're written on the stones from 1 through 10. All right, in the first video, I did the first 5. In this video, I'm dealing with Commandments 6 through 10. But however, here we go. Number 1 says, maintain humanity on the 500 million in perpetual balance with nature. Number 2, guide reproduction wisely, improving fitness and diversity. Number 3, unite humanity with a living new language. Number 4, rule passion, faith, tradition, and all things with tempered reason. Number five, protect people and nations with fair laws and just courts. Number six, let all nations rule internally, resolving external disputes in a world court. Number seven, avoid petty laws and useless officials. Number eight, balance personal rights with social duties. And number nine, prize truth, beauty, love, seeking harmony with the infinite. Be not a cancer on the earth. Leave room for nature. Okay, and actually, and there you have it. Those were those were the Ten Commandments actually that are written on the tablets. But I have featured commandments number 6 through number 10. Okay, so these commandments are somewhat eye-openers to where society and the world at large finds itself in this 21st century. Now, if we would only hear the word of the Lord, we would find answers and solutions to these troubling questions. But the world as it stands will be destroyed and replaced by God because we have not walked in His way. 2 Peter 3 verse 10 reads like this. It says, "But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in which the heavens will pass away with a great noise, and the elements will melt with fervent heat. Both the earth and the works that are in it will be burned up." So we look forward to a new heaven and a new earth, right? As seen by John in Revelation 21. So this has been a two-part series on the Georgia Guidestones that showed up in Elbert County back in 1980. I pray that these videos are helpful to you. And I also pray that you will share the videos with friends and family and tell them to subscribe. Okay, please leave your comments and please like the videos. Please like the videos once again. And if you have not subscribed, I would hope that you will go ahead and subscribe now. So what I want you to do, click the subscribe button right below this window and also click the bell icon so that you will not miss out on any videos that are posted. You'll get a notification whenever a video is posted. My name is William Nelson Ryan, and remember, there's freedom in truth. And until next time, shalom, and may the peace of God be with you.